Let us understand the next concept is sequence impedance and sequence network. So till now we discuss the symmetrical components of the voltages and currents. So these are encountered by these components and depending upon the type of the power system equipment, that is generator, transformer, transmission line and other devices. So before entering into these specific cases, let us define the sequence impedance. So the definition is the impedance of a circuit element when positive sequence current alone are flowing is called positive sequence impedance. Similarly, if the negative sequence current which is flowing, then we'll call it as negative sequence network. And zero sequence impedances similarly. So when only zero sequence currents are present, that is nothing but we'll call it as zero sequence impedances. These impedances are required for component modeling and analysis. So that we are going to discuss in deep of all these concepts. Let us understand the sequence impedance of symmetrical circuit. So from this we are going to understand that, so whether we can be able to apply these sequence impedances for symmetrical circuit and the unsymmetrical circuit. Let us consider with a system that normally balanced initially, we are assuming that, and it is going to be an unbalance only upon the occurrence of there is an unsymmetrical fault. So let us consider that the system, there are the three phases, the current IA, IB and IC, circuit ABC, and we have the return path, that is the neutral, and having the impedance Zn. And we can observe here that the impedance of A, B and the C is same. So that is nothing but Z for entire network and having the neutral of impedance Zn. And you can observe that, so In is equal to Ia plus Ib plus Ic. So it is a meaning that when the system is said to be an unbalanced amount of the current which is flowing in the neutral. So that is the meaning of it. So let us understand the voltage drop which are going to put it as below. So that is nothing but what is the voltage across IA, means the circuit A can be written as the current which is flowing IA, the impedance of Z and the neutral current and the neutral impedance. Okay, so IA into Z plus IN into Zn. So substitute that IN value. So In is equal to Ia plus Ib plus Ic. Okay. So what is the common here? For Ia, it is Z and the Zn. So you'll get Ia multiplied Z plus Zn. And for Ib, it is Zn. And also Ic, it is also Zn. Similarly, which we can apply for Vb and the Vc. For Vb, so for the Ib, it is multiplied by Z plus Zn. So similarly, how we have done for the Va. Okay. And for the Vc, for the Ic, it is multiplied by Z plus Zn. And for the remaining part of the network, that is multiplied by Zn. Okay. So we can write these things in the formation of the matrix. Okay. So left hand side is the voltage Va, Vb, and the Vc. And this is a 3x3 matrix. So we will get, this is only the row matrix. Okay. Sorry, this is nothing but we can consider. So S, okay. Rows and the columns. Okay, these are the rows and these are the column. So when you multiply these rows into the column, we will get only the column matrix. Okay. So then substitute these values by using the sequence components. So that is nothing but for the voltage, we are substituting that the value of the sequence component of the voltages VA0, VA1, VA2 is equal to, can be written as 1 by 3 times of 1, 1, 1, 1, A, A square, 1, A square, A. So this network is same. Okay, the mat means the matrix is same. And for the current, you substitute that the sequence components. Okay, so this is nothing but this is equals to, means we are substituting that this is equal to 1, 1, 1, 1, A square, A, 1, A square multiplied I A naught, I A naught, I A. So you have to be very careful here. We are substituting here. Okay, I A, I B and I C. So this is what the matrix is. Suppose if this means this term is going to the right hand side, this will become 1 by 3 times of 1, 1, 1, 1, A square. Okay. So when we are multiplying that, okay, let us do a multiplication with one this matrix to the this matrix. Okay. So it means that, so this matrix to the this matrix, okay. So we'll get only the diagonal element, okay, because you can see here the lower part of the matrix is A into A square and A square A, and for this here it is A square A and it is A square. Okay, that's why when you multiply these two, you'll get only the diagonal element. So what is this diagonal element is? Z plus 3Z and ZZ, okay. So here, and multiply the value of IA0, IA1 and IA2, okay. So, this is the meaning that VA0 is equal to IA0 into Z plus 3ZN, okay. Let us write these things. So, what we understand from this is, it indicates that symmetrical circuit current of a given sequence produces voltage drop of the given sequence of the voltage drop of the same sequence only. Okay. So that is the sequence impedance are uncoupled in the case of symmetrical circuit. So it is the meaning that, so what we can understand. So if I wanted to VA0 value, okay, so VA0 is equal to IA0 into Z0. So it is a meaning that the voltage is consisting of the same sequence of the current. It means that VA0 is zero sequence voltage is consisting of zero sequence value of the current and the impedance. Similarly, for the positive sequence voltages, it is consisting of the positive sequence current and the impedances. Okay, similarly for the negative. Means there is no correlation from a positive to the negative and negative to the zero. Okay, the same sequence impedance of the value of the voltage consisting of same sequence impedances of the current. So that's why we can apply, we can able to apply these things in the case of the symmetrical circuit. So from this, what we can write is, so here on a single phase basis, which we can apply these things. Okay. So that is nothing but we wanted to write that. Let's do it for a positive, then for the negative and to the zero. Okay. So what is it? VA1, it is IA1 and Z1. Similarly, for what is VA2, it is IA2 and Z2. Okay. What is VA0? VA0 is considering IA0 and the Z0 value. So from this, what we can conclude is that, okay, for a static symmetrical circuit, means for the transformer and the fully transposed transmission line, the positive sequence impedance is same as the negative sequence impedance, but the zero sequence impedance is very large compared to that the positive sequence impedance. So if there is no neutral, okay, here, so means Z0 is consisting of the value of, okay, usually, okay, if it is not neutral, okay, it is not connected to the neutral, so what will happen, this will become, so Z0 will become infinite. That is the meaning. So that's why the neutral is plays an important role when we are dealing with the zero sequence impedance, means zero sequence the value of the voltage and the current. Let us understand that whether we can apply these sequence impedances subjected to that unsymmetrical circuit. So let us look at that, the equations for the three phase circuit when the impedances are unequal. So because of this, then only we can say that the system is said to be unsymmetrical. Okay, let us observe here, the impedance of the circuit is ZA, and for the B it is ZB, and for the C it is ZC. Means these are unequal of having the series impedances. And let us assume that the system is ungrounded and there is no mutual inductance between these components. So let us calculate the what is the voltage drop. Okay, so for this, for the circuit A, we can write it as VA is equal to IA ZA, and for the VB it is IB and the ZB, and for the VC it is IC and the ZC. Okay, so let us write these things in the matrix formation, VA, VB and the VC. So only the diagonal element ZA, ZB and the ZC. Okay, so these are the rows and the columns. Okay, this is nothing but the column matrix. So when the matrix is multiplied by 3 cross 3 into the, okay, the column matrix, so we'll get the column matrix. Okay, so let us express this value of the voltage and the current by sequence components. Okay, so VA, VB and VC can be written as 1 1 1 1 A square A, 1 A square VA0, VA1 and VA2. Okay, similarly for the value of the current, okay, IA, IBC can be written as by using the symmetrical components. Okay, 1 1 1 1 A square A, 1 A square IA0, IA1, IA2. Okay, so taking this matrix, okay, taking this matrix and to the right hand side, okay, multiply with this and do a simplification. So we'll get finally, so VA1, it is 1 by 3 times of IA1, ZA, ZB and ZC, plus 1 by 3 times IA2, ZA plus A square of ZB plus A into ZC, and 1 by 3 times IA0, ZA plus A into ZB plus A square and ZC. So similarly, so VA2 and for the VA0. Okay, so one thing we can observe here, this is 1 1 1, okay, 1 1 1 1, okay, 1 A square A. Okay, so this is 1 A square. So what will happen? Okay, this last term is coming to the first. Okay, and this go to that right shift, and this is again going to the right shift. Okay, you can observe here. Okay, in VA2. Similarly, okay, this is coming first and there is a right shift. Okay, so what is the conclusion from this? Okay, we can conclude that, so this clearly indicates that in the case of unsymmetrical impedances, there is a coupling appears between the sequence network. So because of this, so hence we cannot apply the unsymmetrical components for the sequence impedances, because VA itself is consisting of the positive, negative and zero. Similarly for the VA2 is also consisting of positive, negative and zero. Similarly for the zero sequence network. So that's why we cannot apply this unsymmetrical circuit for the sequence impedances. Let us understand sequence network for the power system elements. So till now we discussed that the three phase unbalanced phases can be resolved into a three balanced system of the phases known as symmetrical components. And also we have proved that in symmetrical system, the current of the one sequence produces voltage drop of the same sequence only. The power system elements like a generator, transformer, transmission lines, generally these are symmetrical in nature. So whenever there is a fault which is occur in a power system, so then the system is going to be an unbalanced. However, by using these symmetrical components, each element can be represented by three distinct balanced decoupled network on a single phase basis. So let us understand one by one. So means the sequence impedance and network for the synchronous generator. Okay, let us see this, the figure. There is a neutral, okay, of the generator is grounded through a reactor having the impedance Zn. When the generator is delivering a balanced load or under symmetrical fault condition, then the neutral current is said to be in zero. But when the generator is delivering an unbalanced load or during unsymmetrical fault, the neutral current, that is Im, which is flows to the neutral from ground via Zn value. Okay, here we are considering that Ea, Eb and okay, for the phase A, B and the C having the induced EMF of the three phases, and similarly Ia, Ib and Ic are the current which are flowing in the lines when a fault takes place at machine terminals. Since the synchronous machine is designed with the symmetrical windings, it induces EMF of positive sequence only. Okay, so this is what Ia, Ib1 and Ic1, okay, having Eg1, Ea for means for the generator, it is Ea1, Eb1 and the Ec1. So this is the figure which shows that, okay, means the positive sequence network model for the synchronous generator. And we can observe here, there is no neutral which is not going to appear in the case of the generator model. And this is nothing but In is said to be zero for the positive sequence currents. So let us mean EAEB, EA1, EB1 and EC1 is the positive sequence generated voltage and having the impedance of Z1, okay, for the positive sequence impedance because of the balanced and symmetrical nature of the system, means we are representing on a single phase basis. Okay, by means this is the positive sequence network. So from this, so we can write it down. That's nothing but this is the induced EMF and this is nothing but VA1 is the terminal voltage. So terminal voltage will become VA1 is equal to EA1 minus IA1 Z1. So what is EA1? So it is same as the generated EMF. Okay, EA minus IA1 Z1. Okay, so if the armature resistance is assumed negligible, that the per phase positive sequence impedance Z1 of the machine, we can write it as it is mainly depending upon the subtransient, transient and steady state period. Okay, and let us understand for the negative sequence current part. Okay, so here by using on as we can represent on a single phase basis. Okay, so here we can observe that induced voltages are not present, whereas in case of the negative sequence current path, okay, because as they are not generated in synchronous machine. However, whenever there is a fault or unbalanced load, the zero sequence means the negative sequence current can flow in the machine. Since negative sequence current do not flow in the neutral, so that's why the Zn is not going to appear in the case of the negative sequence part. Okay, so from this we can write it as Va2 is equal to, it is minus Ia2 and Z2, because what is the current direction, assumed direction, which are same. Okay, so impedances of the positive and negative sequence current are not the same in the case of the synchronous machine because of the some of the reasons. So these reasons are because the sequence of negative current is in direction which is opposed to that of the phase sequence of the positive sequence current. So with the flow of these negative sequence current, whereas in case of the stator, so there is a rotating field which is created, which rotates in opposite direction to that of the positive sequence field, and therefore at double synchronous speed, with respect to that of the rotor. So this field does not encounter the same opposition that of the positive sequence field, so which rotates at the synchronous speed. So these currents at double the stator frequency are therefore induced in the rotor field and damper windings. Okay, so resulting in this negative sequence MMF is alternately presented with reluctance of direct and quadrature axis. So these are all the things. There is a lot of things to understand that we are not going in deep to the concept. So let us understand for zero sequence. So these zero sequence voltages are not induced in a synchronous machine. So whenever the system is unbalanced or there is a fault, so if a neutral path which is exist, then the zero sequence current flows through the neutral, okay, with the help of the impedance Zn. So we can observe here it is In is equal to, it is the 3 times of In0. Already we discussed that why it is so, because there is no phase angle between IIB and the IC for the zero. Okay, so these zero sequence current in all phases are of the same magnitude and the phase angle it is zero. Okay, so when only zero sequence current flow in armature winding, the current and the MMF of one phase are at maximum at a same time as the current and the MMF of the other two phases. So resulting in the air gap field caused by these zero sequence current is therefore zero. So hence the rotor windings present leakage reactance and the reactance of the N turns only as impedance to the flow of the zero sequence current. Hence, the reactance of the N turns is very small compared to the leakage reactance. Hence, these zero sequence reactance means ZG0 is almost same as the leakage reactance of the machine. However, so when zero sequence current flows through the neutral point, the impedance which is connected to the ground, which means connected to the ground, which limits the zero sequence current as well. So hence the impedance which is connected to the neutral point is included in zero sequence impedance of the machine. Means we are considering both the things, ZG0 and the ZN value. Okay, so this is the current path and this is on a single phase basis. So means we are considering that the current, it is a 3 times I0, which is produced then 3 I not and the ZN value. Okay, to show on these things on a single phase network, so we are going to write this is nothing but Z0 is equal to, it is 3 times of ZN plus ZG0. And we understood that why it is a 3, because of the there is no phase shift, means the angle between IIB and the IC for these zero sequence. Okay, and for this voltage drop, okay, we can write it as means the terminal voltage V0 is equal to minus I0 Z0. So we can observe here I Z0 is nothing but it is 3 Zn plus Zg0. Okay, when the star point is ungrounded, so what will happen? The neutral impedance, we are assuming that it is infinite. So hence, so Z0 will become infinite because it has a very low value of the impedance. Okay, So this is the one of the example where the neutral is not connected to a ground point. Okay, so hence this is the one of the example. So this is the applicable, whereas in case of the zero sequence for the synchronous generator.